Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet. I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Recognize me, do you, Ryder?
You think you're God?
You think you can just make up stuff?
Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama? You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer!
You're a joke. It would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your
editor.
You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories.
'Cause I'm gonna kill you.
It's not like your stories are any
good.
Not like they have any
artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills
and pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
You missed your
deadline!
Damn. You can't
stop me!
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own
creation?
No! No!
I was trapped. There was no way out.
This, for he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. You coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. This way, there's no time. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun. Pick up the revolver.
Now you'll die.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Thank you.
Shh, baby. Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here. Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Mayne, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Mayne, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car. Come on.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all of your books.
I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
Right.
Are you on your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
Sonny, I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. Ha!
You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Yes, that's my favorite tune. Coconut.
Shut your mouth, you demented has-been. If I had my
now,
hammer,
that's what I'm talking about.
You.
Yes. Jeez.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key
you?
And get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans
listen.
Always did.
I told Rose last week that she should change the bulb. This is what happens when you get sloppy.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Me
That sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah. Splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Don. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
I'll be heading back to work as soon as Dr. Hartman gets here, Rose. Oh, but I'm not looking forward to the poison we have at the Park Cafe.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Bad man here. I'm PBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Are you sure you read the directions right? It's nothing like in the brochure. It said near the lake, not on it. Don't get me wrong. This is so much better. It's wonderful. Our own private island.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside. Come on.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Sure thing. I'm on it.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Hello? Anyone here?
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned. I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s. Or even earlier.
Guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. A famous artist, no less, but we'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBFFM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it? He's my favorite writer.
Well, Rose,
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Maine on KBFFM. And now, some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile. The water was clear but dark. It looked very deep.
There's probably a fuse box or a generator in the shed.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again. Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public. An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
A bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Alice? Honey?
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
keeps... Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice! God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice! I'm coming! It's all right! I'm coming! Oh, no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice? crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartmann. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night. Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
I've been in an accident!
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you.
non-refundable reservation deposit required. Fair and square.
Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
During your trying
Nordic walking.
It's the latest
thing.
Incontestably proven health benefits let you
kill two birds with
one
stone.
You can see the sights.
Yes.
And keep those cholesterol.
Right, Paul Sheriff Station.
Yeah. Stone.
Hello? Hello?
Torn.
This is bad.
Trying
Nordic walking.
It's the latest
thing.
Incontestably proven.
Yes.
Let you
kill.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. Oh, man.
Stone.
Hello? Hello?
And keep those cholesterol levels.
This is bad. The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
caution. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station. When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water. Was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong. Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Occupation!
eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it. The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site. This forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top. I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes. Black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs. Thank you.
I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find him.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks, Pat.
You have a good night now.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice. The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no
contest. Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is
third.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman. "The cabin on Cauldron Lake?" she asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
To advance it, to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
Takes
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive. I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting, at least for a moment. The sane world reasserted itself. The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now. Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him. I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Thank you.
Right Falls Sheriff Station.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
Colored clown, they call the Sandman, tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away into night. I softly say a silent prayer, like dreamers do. Then I fall asleep to dream my dreams of you. In dreams I walk with you. In dreams I talk to you. In dreams you're mine. All of the time we're together.
If I cry, I remember that you said
on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at, but the cabin had disappeared.
I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow. Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
The continuing freezing rain and heavy snowfall have necessitated a winter storm warning in the entire tri-state area. People are advised to stay indoors, as many roadways are already closed, and city officials are not expecting snow crews to keep up with the weather. We're now on the third day of the blizzard, and the weather is not expected to clear up anytime soon.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake. Thinking in metaphors again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me. This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine. Just get the lights back on. Now, please.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, Ryder boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small-town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head. I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
Miss Weaver, everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bolts will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
I'll be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor. that was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that. Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
Alice was missing. I needed help to find her. I wasn't ready to leave.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.